Hey fellow animators, I'm Miloš Černý, and today I will talk about motion layers, which are available in CAD animation system. Motion layers are kind of special ones, and they represent procedural animation in 3ds Max. This is part 3 of my layers video series, but I decided to post it as a separate video, because this topic requires a bit more attention. In previous videos about animation layers, I said that most of the information in them can be applied to other softwares as well, not just 3ds Max. Which is true, but that is not the case with CAD's motion layers. Procedural character animation, which these layers are providing for you, is extremely rare. Neither Maya or Motion Builder have it, and to my knowledge, none of those you would consider big 3D softwares have it either. Yes, there are probably some scripts or ways how to do it in different softwares maybe, so don't quote me on that. I don't use other softwares on daily basis and things like these change in time of course, but as far as I know, 3ds Max and CAD especially are quite unique in this area. So let's get to it. For those who don't know, procedural animation means that you animate by changing parameters and not by keyframing like you usually do. Because of this, procedural animation excels in cyclic movements, most commonly walk, trot, run and stuff like that, but you can do some more crazier stuff as well. Unfortunately, I cannot teach you everything in short videos like this, but I will try to explain the tools and things you can do with them, and basically let you know that they even exist. So let's create a motion layer. Again, you can see the acronym for it here. Because it is a motion layer, this button changes from Layer Transform Gizmo to CAD Motion Editor. So let's open it. Almost everything you do with this layer, you do in this window. Every time you create a motion layer, you will get some movement with default values right away. Something to start from. But of course, as you can see, it still requires a lot of editing anyways, to get something useful. In this window, however, you can find parameters for each bone hub in your rig. These names are equal to the names of your bones, so don't forget to rename them to something reasonable as you create a rig. You can play with these values to get the look you want. However, for the sake of this video, and because the video is not about creating a walk cycle, I will load the clip with finished animation I have done before. You can see it added a new motion layer to the stack, because the clip had one motion layer saved in it. So let's say you have got to this point with your animation and you are pretty satisfied. Just to remind you, this animation was done just by changing values in Motion Editor window. Not a single keyframe was set. In the future, I will probably make a separate tutorial about that, but today I want to show you why you would even want to do the animation this way and not by regular keyframing. So let's head to global stuff. And here, just by clicking on Walk on Line button, you make the animation play in space. Which is often useful to see, because these cycles feel a lot different when seen moving in space, and you probably want them to be nice in both situations. But even more incredible thing, the path node. I will show you. I have animated a box here with this trajectory. It's just moving forward and a bit to the right. But let's pick this box as path node for our character and see what happens. It's rotated the wrong way, so let's fix that. And let's see. He stops right there at frame 30. That's because we have end set it up to 30, so fix that as well. Now you see he moves to the end and he follows the path. He is strafing to the side and he even keeps his feet on the ground without any sliding. But at the beginning he is standing still for a while because the box starts at frame 0. So let's animate it a bit further back. and set start for walk to frame minus 30 as well. Now start the animation at frame 0 again. And you can see his legs are mid walk already at this frame, which looks better. You can even animate rotation for the box if you want him to follow the path and not strafe. Something like this, for example. And you see he rotates as he walks. Feet still firmly on the ground, no sliding. But that's not all. You can even select the footsteps get created for you. And move them. That is insane! You still animated just one walk cycle. I guarantee you that you would have to be looking very hard for something similar with these features. But why stop there? Let's set up a value for direction. The value is in degrees, so 90 for example, and he starts to walk sideways 90 degrees. Or 45. Or backwards. Of course you have to edit the animation a bit to make it look okay, but you have 80% done already. Some other things you can change. Maybe speed up the animation. Or slow down. Maybe make him do longer steps. Or shorter. You can change limb phases. Maybe make him look like he is jumping forward. This needs a lot more editing, of course. But I think you get the idea where this can get you. And of course, the motion layer is still just a layer. If you want to do some extra changes, you can just apply adjustment layer without any problems and edit whatever you want. So that's it for now. These are still just a few examples, but the video is quite long already. I hope it showed you the potential of procedural animation. It works really well for creating basic movement animations for your game character, for example. But it has many uses. With Path Node, you can easily create crowds of people following paths with just one animation or few variations of it. Or create a living environment for your visualizations, for example, with people walking around and so on. Even though 3ds Max has crowd simulations implemented since version 2015, I believe, so you can use that for visualizations, but it has its limitations. With motion layers you have control over everything. I am Miloš Černý and thank you for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe if you like my videos. Share them on your local 3D or animation websites. Somebody shared my octopus tutorials on 3d1.com.br site in language I don't understand, so thank you for that. Or just leave a comment and like, or watch my previous videos. Thank you.